Welcome to Salesforce Rangers. In this video, we are going to learn the browser debugger. You know, you must have seen your seniors, your senior developers doing something in the browser debugger, which you know, some of you may not have any clue about it, that what is happening. You can see it right here in the window. I have opened this. This is called browser debugger. Every browser has this feature. So let's start. So this is my account record page, account detail page, and I have put a custom lightning component over here. And I can open the browser debugger by pressing F12 or Control Shift plus I if we are using a Windows system, operating system. So this opens, this is our browser debugger. It contains many tabs. We are going to talk about some of them, some of the important tabs of this debugger. Now let's see that what is happening inside our lightning component, which we have put here. Learn how to use browser debugger. This is my component, and I have an attribute record ID, which is storing my current record ID. And there is a handler, which is running on the load of this component. And we have this JavaScript function attached to this handler. And let's get to this JavaScript doInit function. In this, we are storing this record ID. We are into this variable. Now, there are many ways by which we can, start the browser debugging, and we can see that what's the issue in our JavaScript code. So simply, either you can write console.log and type ACC ID, or okay, let's first see how console.log works. I am going to refresh it so that my Lightning component code gets updated, and I will open this console tab. You can see that the record ID is printed over here, and you can see this is the record ID of my current account. Now if you see till the end and click on this link here, it will open the JavaScript code of my Lightning component. There it is. See the doInit function and console.log. Now I will show you another way to debug this. I will remove console.log and type debugger semicolon. What it's going to do, I'm going to refresh the component. It's going to stop the execution where I have put the debugger. See, it is written that paused in debugger. The execution is paused at this line when we write debugger. Now what we can do is, either we can resume it from here by pressing F8, or we can execute one line at a time, one by one, by pressing F10 or this little icon here. So this is step over next function call. This executes the next line and pauses again, and then if you press it again, then it will execute the next line and then pause again. But if we press this, then it's going to resume the whole execution. So this debugger can also be a helpful way to debug your JavaScript code. Now I will show you some of the, we will get into more details. What we can do is, we have a watch. There is a feature called watch. Expand it and press this plus icon and write your variable name, or anything which you want to for which you want to know the value. So I have put ACC ID and pressed enter. So it shows me the value of this variable right at this line. What is the value of this variable at this line of code? So using this watch variable, we can debug many things in our code. And if I press F10 or press this icon or this icon here, it's going to the next line of code. Then I press it again, then the code is finished. So it has opened the JavaScript file. Now okay, so for the beginners, these two things, the debugger and the watch, these two things they will help you quite a lot while debugging your JavaScript code if you are a beginner. And elements tab, this is the HTML where we want to change our HTML or CSS. For example, I want to change the UI of this label here. So I will right click on it and inspect. Then it will open my HTML. Now I can apply any CSS here. For example, font size 20px. You see, the font size is increased automatically. So we don't need to change in the Lightning component code. We can just test by applying the CSS from this debugger, and then after everything seems fine, you can move your code to your move this CSS to your Lightning component, or move the HTML changes to your Lightning component. Now we have talked about elements and console tab. We have another tab called sources, where all the local resources are available. For example, you can see that SLDS is there. SLDS is Lightning Design System. We have the fonts and the images. Now there is components. These are all standard stuff. Now if we want to check our components JavaScript, where it is stored? It is stored in this component/c, and this is our component and this is our JavaScript file of that component. So we can now another way to debugger, to alternative of this debugger, is we put this a checkpoint. We can put a checkpoint here and here, and this is going to behave just like this debugger. It's going to pause the execution at this particular line, and when you resume, then it's going to move to the next line, and if another checkpoint is there, then it's going to pause the execution again. So we can remove the checkpoints for now, but just wanted to show you that checkpoints are also there, which behaves like debugger as well. All right, so then we have network tab. In the network tab, we can see how are the components, or how are the images, CSS, JavaScript file are getting loaded in our application, any web application. So first of all, this browser debugger is not only for the Salesforce developers, but for all those developers who are into web development, web application development. Now we can see that there are multiple options: XHR, which is REST request, and JS, JavaScript files, or the JavaScript file. We can see that whether it is loaded successfully or not. So sometimes we are using external libraries of JavaScript and custom CSS files, and sometimes these files don't work. So you can come to this tab directly and check whether your file got loaded in the first place or not. If it is not loaded, then first fix that and then try to debug your code. So performance, nothing much here. Memory, nothing much here as well. Application, in the application tab, you can keep a watch on the cookies. So in this on this web page, these are the cookies stored. You can create and delete the cookies as well, manipulate the cookies from here. So for the beginners, this information about browser debugger is sufficient, and I hope you will not face any issues while using browser debugger now. If you face it, please watch my video and help yourself. Thank you for watching this. Have a good day.